We want to solve the equation 1.6x equals negative 0.8. We can also read this equation as 1 6/10 x equals negative 8/10. Because 1.6x means 1.6 times x, the solution to the equation is the value of x that makes the product on the left equal to negative 0.8. To solve for x, we need to isolate x on one side of the equation, and because x is on the left side, our solution will be in the form x equals some value, again, that makes this product equal to negative 0.8. So again, because 1.6x means 1.6 times x, to solve for x, we need to undo this multiplication by performing the opposite operation or the inverse operation. Well, the opposite operation of multiplication is division, and therefore to solve for x, we need to divide both sides of the equation by 1.6. If we divide one side of the equation by 1.6, we must divide the other side by 1.6 to maintain equality. Now looking at the left side of the equation, notice how we have 1.6 divided by 1.6, which equals 1. So the left side simplifies to 1x, and 1x is just x. Another way to think of this is that dividing by 1.6 undoes the multiplication involving 1.6, and therefore this simplifies perfectly to just the variable x. On the left side, we need to find this quotient in order to determine our solution. Notice how we have a negative divided by a positive, which means this quotient is going to be negative. So let's go ahead and put a negative sign here and here. Now we'll perform the division without the negative sign here on the side. So we'll have 0.8 divided by 1.6. Again, we're leaving the sign off here because we already put a negative sign in our solution. When performing division involving decimals, we want the divisor to be a whole number. To make 1.6 a whole number, we would have to multiply by 10 or move the decimal point to the right one place to here, and we can do this as long as we do the same to the dividend. So now move the decimal point to the right one place in the dividend here. Move the decimal point up into the quotient and divide like we normally do. Notice how we change the division problem from 0.8 divided by 1.6 to 8 divided by 16, but the quotient will be the same. So we first need to determine how many 16s there are in 8. Well, there are 0 16s in 8. 0 times 16 is 0, and we subtract. 8 minus 0 is 8. Because we want the quotient as a decimal, we need to keep dividing. To do this, we add a 0 to the right of the decimal point in the dividend here. By adding a 0 here, because the decimal point, we're not changing the value of the dividend. Now we can bring the 8 down and determine how many 16s there are in 80. And there are exactly 5 16s in 80. So we'll place a 5 here in the quotient and check our multiplication. 5 times 6 is 30. Perform an exchange with a 3. 5 times 1 is 5 plus 3, which equals 8. So 5 times 16 is 80. And because the difference is 0, our quotient is 0.5, which means our solution, remember, is negative. So our solution is 1x equals negative 0.5, which means x equals negative 0.5. A lot of times you won't see this step here because, again, 1x is just x. Before we go, though, let's check our solution by substituting negative 0.5 for x in the original equation. Performing the substitution, we would have 1.6 times negative 0.5 equals negative 0.8. Let's check this product on the calculator to make sure it is negative 0.8. So 1.6 times negative 0.5, again, is negative 0.8 or negative 0.8, which verifies our solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.